And so I came out to my parents the fall of my senior year. So it's been about 4 years now, which is hard to believe. I came out to my parents. It was a disaster. I mean, I knew it was going to be bad, and I thought I had prepared for the worst, but it was so much worse than I imagined it would be. And but I got through it, and I told my mom. I thought she would be... I guess it was a dream in my head that my mom, I knew she would be upset, but she would ultimately be like, you know, Jordan, you're right. We'll love you as you are. We'll accept this. And that was just totally a fantasy because my mother freaked out. The moment I told her, she instantly burst into tears and was calling my father, you need to get home. We have a situation to take care of. Like, it was intense. And I don't know. My dad and I have never really been close, and I hate to say that, but it's true. And you know, he exploded. He was determined to put me into some programs. I mean, there's tons of programs. I mean, like Exodus is a very well-known one. Turn your gay kids straight programs, and I was terrified. I didn't know what to do. I mean, I want to make my parents happy. I still do. And it seemed like, well, maybe this is what I should do. Maybe I can fix all of this. Maybe I can just dive into this and come out a normal person. It was such a hard thing to deal with. But ultimately, I decided, no, you know, I'm not going to do that. I've spent years getting to where I'm at now, and I can't backtrack. I have to keep moving forward. And so that's exactly what I did. I told my parents, you know, I'm not going to try to fix something that's not broken. I've spent so many years thinking that I was broken and that I needed to be fixed, but I've come to a space where I realize that nothing is broken. All is perfect. All is the way it should be. And I stood firm in that. And my parents, to this day, think that I'm in a phase, I'm in a stage, something, it'll change eventually, I'll snap out of it, but the further they go down that path, the further I go down my path, which is the path of self-discovery and self-assurance and bravery and courage and learning to just be proud of who I am, which is a daily process that I'm working with. Feel that I've made huge progress, absolutely huge progress, and I'm really proud of myself for going against that grain, going against my family. You know, that's a hard thing to do. To go against your family is a very difficult place to be, but I've done it, and they love me. I know they do. In the depths of their hearts, they love me. And we can interact and be fine as long as this small part of me is swept under the rug. We can interact perfectly. And actually, I think my father and I's relationship has grown exponentially from me coming out to them. I mean, because we had nothing in common. And then when I came out, we both realized that, wow, we really are on the polar opposite ends of the spectrum. And so now we're trying to gain ground, we're trying to make some middle ground, trying to find something that connects us together. And, I mean, we're working with it. It's a steady, ongoing process. Where will it lead? I have no idea, but I know that I have to stay strong in who I am, you know, and let them deal with it how they need to deal with it. You know, life is too short to bury things away. So I'm just being who I am, and I'm not afraid to tell them that. And their reactions are always negative. But I have to sweep that off my shoulder, because this is my life, and my happiness is what I need to focus on, not trying to please other people, not even my parents, not trying to please them, because some beliefs are so ingrained that I couldn't even expect them to change. Not within a 4-year period. That's to make those kind of fundamental changes in one's belief structure doesn't happen over a month, a year, 4 years, a decade. You know, it's a very slow process. And the only thing I can do is to let them know how steady I am in the idea of knowing that I am created perfectly. That being gay is perfectly in line with who I'm supposed to be. So if I have a message that I could offer to people, I mean, especially those of you in small southern towns with really conservative religious parents. I've been there, and I know how terrifying it can be. But you have to live your life for yourself. You have to do the things and make the choices that align yourself with the happiness that you deserve. And being proud of your sexuality in those situations is tough. But I know for me, the moment I spoke those words to my parents, it was shackles that had been accumulating over so many years that were just instantly freed. And it was, I would never change that for the world. And sure, you go through turmoil and hardships and lots of angry arguments and tears, but I mean, at the end of the day, when you lay your head on the pillow, you feel proud, you feel courageous, and there's nothing I would do to change that away from myself, because it's the motivation that I need to keep pushing myself, to keep being more and more open and who I am. And if you have any questions, any comments, any stories, feel free to contact me. I mean, because I would love to talk about it. I would love to relate with people who have that same experience. And there are so many of us out there. So many. It's crazy. But anyway, just thought I would share a bit of my story. It might spark some ideas in my head to make future videos. I don't know. Anyway, I hope you're having a wonderful day. Peace be with you.